Grownheadz.com.
Hey, once again it's on. It's another episode of Grownhead Convo. I'm DJ AC, and taking part in the conversation today we have...
Hey, Rocker, from the left coast.
Resident alien in Miami.
The hip-hop purist from Huntsville, Alabama.
And the question of the day is... What does Common have to do to break the glass ceiling of greatness? He seems like he's almost good, he's almost great, he's almost classic. What does he have to do? Resident alien.
It seems like his lyrics are very unfocused. You know, like, I'll say this. To me, Common's greatest sense is his storytelling. You know, I used to love her, Payback as a Grandmother, you know, even like, what was that song, Testify. You know what I'm saying? He weaves a very good story, but when he just does those, his other kind of songs, where he's almost like stream of consciousness, it always feels like just real unfocused, and you know, like, huh? Like he just sort of meanders off. I don't know. I don't want to say too much. I don't want to sound mean.
Anyway, hip hop peers. How do you feel about Common and greatness?
Well, we had this conversation earlier. I think he focuses too much time on love songs, personally. If he stopped doing that, I think he'd be okay. If he would focus all that effort into making something profound instead of trying to make, you know, songs to get groupies, I think he'd be okay. I feel the same way about LL.
LL did here. But so you're saying that if he did not make love songs, he'd be great.
Yeah, you like what Murder did on his last album, have the songs love songs. I don't want to hear all that.
Love is so important. But don't we need love today? Hip hop here? Don't we need love today?
Yeah, we got it. We got the OJs, the Temptations. We got all them old school Dusty Marvin Gaye songs. Why we gotta have it in rap? I wanna hear about fishing and flying airplanes and climbing trees. I want to hear about pine cones and blades of grass and beetles. I don't want to hear about love all the time.
but hip hop peers, you're saying we need some more nature rappers in it.
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying Common spends too much time trying to make popular songs when he should just spend time making songs. Songs that he feels. Songs that's coming from the depths of him.
Okay, well, K-Rocka.
Almost good, almost great. What is the other almost you said?
Almost classic, almost great, almost. Or in your opinion, he might be there. He might be, you know, when you list the top five rappers, he's there. I mean, you might just be like, nah, he's there. That's him. He's up there.
I mean, all those almost sounds like, I mean, he's in the category. It means he's going to drop enough and means he's putting out enough material to make you like, okay, he is, you know, he's damn near that good, you know. Are you gonna hit the ball out the park every time you step up the bat? No, but is he gonna come with enough to, like, you know, make you reflect that, okay, this dude is one of the better rappers out there? I mean, I'm scouring through, I'm doing a homework on this. I'm like, every list you look at, he's in there as the top, you know, 10 or top 20 right now. It's kind of a band.
Well, the thing to me though, it's like, I don't think if going with the sports allegory, that if he's the guy that you'll always get to the playoffs, you always come close, you might even get to the conference finals, but he just ain't. It's like Vince Carter. He'll get you there, he'll make some highlights, it's like, dang! But when it comes down to it, he's not going to take you to the promised land. I think that's the problem.
What do we want the promised land to be? I mean, he's still kind of respected on the underground. What are we looking for? He don't sell a shitload of records, it's pretty conscious. He hasn't really sold himself out. I mean, he has done some stuff, you know, kind of commercial here and there, but I'm pretty sure, you know, everybody at some point, if you want to stay in this business, you're going to have to bend a little bit. He ain't went too far.
That's true. Actually, you know what? You're right about that, Keith. I agree with that.
You're making us feel bad now. Like, well, maybe he is.
I'm just trying to say, what are we looking for?
I mean, you're making a good case. Yeah. I mean, I'm like, well,
I mean...
But he's still, but he, I mean, understand though, we're not saying he ain't great. We're not saying he ain't really good.
Y'all saying he's not great.
And he's great.
I'm saying
that's exactly what we said.
But no, but great. I mean, a lot of it's hard to be great. I mean, they're great, but it's like there's bastards. Michael Jordan, there's Magic Johnson, and then there's, you know, Vince Carter, and then there's Fat Lever. You know what I'm saying? Good players.
There's the pyramid.
Yeah, and he ain't the bottom. He ain't like, oh, he sucks. But he ain't the top. But the problem is he's close to the top, and I think most, at least I feel, he could be at the top. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know, man. You need some Scottie Pippens, man.
And it's not bad. You're right. It ain't bad being Scottie Pippen. Time.
Ooh.
I know. Farewell is such sweet sorrow. Well, that does it for Grownheadz Convo. Join us for more conversation on the site for adults who love hip-hop, Grownheadz.com.